tonight.
I don't know what I did to be given the gift of Belinda Emmett. Whatever it was, I'm glad I did it. Because it allowed me the opportunity of sharing laughter and tears with my best friend.
Family.
Many people have sent messages. Prime Minister John Howard, Russell Crowe, Bono, Kylie and Danny.
Friends.
Rose, you were her hero. And I'll never forget you watching you and Belle dance the bridal waltz.
And a nation. Farewell, a beautiful young woman. Hello, I'm Charmaine Dragoon and welcome to 10's Late News. Goodbye, Belinda. Family, friends and fans today paying their last respects to Belinda Emmett. For Rove McManus, it was a heartbreaking return to the same church where they married.
A sea of flowers cascaded over the casket of Belinda Emmett at Mary Immaculate Church in Waverley. A sea of friends flowed in shortly after. Famous faces Belinda had worked with during her acting career. Close friends of her and husband Rove, and of course family, devastated to have lost this talented and warm young woman at just 32. Glenn and Jane McGrath were there. In lieu of flowers, the family has asked for donations to be made to fellow breast cancer sufferer Jane McGrath's foundation. And finally, Rove, who met the love of his life 7 years ago this week.
Many people have sent messages. Prime Minister John Howard, Russell Crowe, Bono, Kylie and Danny.
As a crowd of well-wishers gathered to listen outside, inside a eulogy from family friend Father Tim McEwen, who spoke on behalf of Rove.
He said, I don't know what I did to be given the gift of Belinda Emmett, but whatever it was, I'm glad I did it, because it allowed me the opportunity of sharing laughter and tears with my best friend for 7 wonderfully unforgettable years.
And to Rove, you were her hero. And I'll never forget you watching you and Belle dance the bridal waltz. You danced it with your eyes.
And today, in the same church where they married in January last year, the congregation witnessed the depth of Rove and Belinda's love in a video of that bridal waltz. And a moving video tribute. Throughout the service, we got to hear Belinda's own voice, 2 songs she recorded before she died. This one, called It's Just Nice, and one that's been released to radio today, called Less Than Perfect. Belinda wouldn't have wanted the day to end on too sad a note. The choice of song to play as her coffin was carried out of the church, indicative of the couple's shared sense of humour. Always look on the bright side of life. Belinda Emmett's A Life to be Celebrated and Remembered.